got to win the game to the people who run it, to the people who own it, that unless you're free, the machine will be prevented from working at all, from working at all, from working at all.
Don't lay down and die because a new world order, the business of the day for the elite, when they're coming to take your freedoms away.
Hello again, human beings from the planet Earth. You know, every time I bring you guys a headline or I learn something new, or I have to reiterate something else, I just can't imagine how much longer until everybody snaps all at once. The whole country just comes fucking unglued. When is enough? Okay? Now we find out that 100 drugs were created on fraudulent science. They forged and got them through. Now, when I read this to you, you should be fucking horrified. And keep in mind, FDA is equal to United States government. Okay? They're equal in this situation. You need to consider that, all of you that are trying to find a way to hold the government together. You don't want to be labeled as a terrorist because you think that the government is corrupt and needs to be exchanged for one that suits the values of the nation. What are you going to allow? Now, after I read this to you, you're going to understand that we have people that could have died, probably did die. We have people that are addicted to painkillers because probably maybe they were a little stronger than they needed to be just to create that addiction. I don't know. Let me give you the post instead of my speculation, okay? That's what you came here for. Enough about my ramblings. Okay, on the morning of May 3rd, 2010, three agents of the Food and Drug Administration descended upon the Houston office of Sotero Research, a firm that conducted research for drug companies worldwide. Lead agent Patrick Stone, now retired from the FDA, had visited the Houston lab many times over the previous decade for routine inspections. This time was different. His team was there to investigate a former employee's allegation that the company had tampered with records and manipulated test data. When Stone explained the gravity of the inquiry to Chinna Pamidi, the testing facility's president, the Sotero executive made a brief phone call. Moments later, employees rolled in 8 flatbed carts, each double-stacked with file boxes. The documents represented 5 years of data from some 1,400 drug trials. Pamidi bluntly acknowledged that much of the lab's work was fraudulent. Stone said, "You got us." Stone recalled him saying, "Based partly on records in the file boxes, the FDA eventually concluded the lab's violations were so egregious and of such a pervasive nature that studies conducted there between April 2005 and August 2009 might be worthless. The health threat was potentially serious. About 100 drugs, including sophisticated chemotherapy compounds and addictive prescription painkillers, had been approved for sale in the United States, at least in part on the strength of Sotero Houston's tainted test. The vast majority, 81, were generic versions of brand-name drugs on which Sotero scientists had run critical tests to determine whether the copies did, in fact, act the same in the body as the originals. For example, one of these generic drugs was ibuprofen, sold as gelatin capsules by one of the nation's largest grocery store chains for months before the FDA received assurance that they were safe. The rest were new medications that required so much research to win approval that the FDA says Sotero's tests were rarely crucial." Stone said he expected the FDA to move swiftly to compel new testing and publicly warn patients and doctors. Instead, the agency decided to handle the matter quietly, evaluating the medications with virtually no public disclosure of what it had discovered. It pulled none of the drugs from the market, even temporarily, letting consumers take the ibuprofen and other medication it no longer knew for sure were safe and effective. To this day, some drugs remain on the market, despite the FDA having no additional scientific evidence to back up the safety and efficacy of the drugs. By contract, the FDA's transatlantic counterpart, the European Medicines Agency, has pulled 7 Sotero-tested medicines from the market. The FDA also moved slowly to shore up the science behind the drugs. Twice the FDA announced it was requiring drug makers to repeat, reanalyze, or audit many of Sotero's tests and to submit their findings to the agency. Both times the agency set deadlines, yet it has allowed some companies to blow by them. Today, 6 months after those The last of those deadlines expired, and almost 3 years after Sotero's misconduct was discovered, the FDA has received the required submissions for just 53 drugs. The agency says most companies met the deadlines, but acknowledged that a few... What do you mean a few? Almost half. There were 100. You got 53. That's 47. That's pretty close to 50%. I don't know, off the top of my head, is it 48? I don't know. I'm not doing the math. It's close enough to half. Bullshit, a few. Other companies said it had not submitted new research because they removed their drugs from the market altogether. Well, we still want the science to find out what damage you've caused, asshole. Oh, Jesus. Here, before I start to rant, let me read. For this part, the FDA has finished its review of just 21 of the 53 submissions it had received, raising the possibility that patients are taking medication today that the agency might pull off the market tomorrow. To this day, the agency refuses to disclose the names of the drugs it is reassessing on the grounds that doing so would expose confidential commercial information. ProPublica managed to identify 5 drugs that were used by Sotero tests with help of FDA approval. FDA officials defended the agency's handling of the Sotero case as prudent and scientifically sound. Bullshit. Noting that the agency had found no discrepancies between any original drug and its generic copy and no sign that any patients had been harmed. Well, first of all, they don't fucking know if they've been harmed. And second of all, you've only processed roughly a quarter of the drugs that are fraudulently tested. So don't give me any bullshit about science and safety and bullshit. Millions of dollars to your fucking constituents are going to be lost, and we want the information. Woodcock added that an agency risk assessment found the potential for harm from drugs tested by Sotero to be quite low. Excuse me, the ibuprofen destroys the liver anyway. Okay? So, bullshit. That's just ibuprofen. We're not talking about any opiates because strong painkillers, probably opiate-based, right? Okay, let me just read. She declined to release the risk assessment or detail its design. A subsequent statement from the agency described the assessment as fluid and ongoing. The FDA has also not released its 21 completed reviews, which ProPublica had requested. Some experts say that by withholding so much information in the Sotero case, the FDA failed to meet its obligations to the public. Abso-fucking-lutely. Absolutely. If there are problems with the scientific studies, and there have been in this case, then the FDA's review of those problems needs to be transparent, said David Kessler, who headed the FDA from 1990 to 1997 and who is now a professor at the University of California at San Francisco. Putting its reviews in public view would let the medical community understand the basis for the agency's actions, he said. The FDA may be right here, but if it wants public confidence, they should be transparent. Otherwise, it's just a black box. Well, wait a minute. The people are still taking medications. They may have developed other health problems because of this medication. They need to check themselves. They need that information so that they can see if they've had other health effects, if it's related to the difference in the medication. Because many people are taking the generic form. You know that. And that's all your medical will pay for. You don't get the name brand stuff when you have state or government medical. You get the generic. So the government's filling people with generic drugs that they can't prove are safe. And they won't release that information to you. And everything is fucking fine. Everything. I'm not even reading anymore. I've had enough. God damn it. When are you going to have enough? The link will be below.